Let us see some more working examples on linear or non-linear systems. Here I have given 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 systems I have given. Let us check out whether these systems are linear or non-linear systems. Let us see one by one. So let us say, what is the first equation? The first equation is, so y of n is equal to n square into x of n. So this is the input to the system, this is the response or output of the system. When this input is given to the system, simply the system will multiply with n square and give the response of the system. So let us say if x1 of n is the input to the system, what is the output? Y1 of n. So that is what system will do, simply multiply the input x1 of n with n square. So let us apply x2 of n to the system. Let us say the response is y2 of n, so that is equal to n square into x2 of n. So first let us add the individual responses. Let us call this as y3 of n, so that is equal to a into y1 of n plus b into y2 of n. So let us add the individual responses. So therefore you can write it as y3 of n is equal to a into n square into x1 of n plus b into n square into x2 of n. So let us see what next step we have to do. We have to apply linear combination of inputs to the system. So that means in place of x of n, we apply the linear combination of inputs to the system. Or you can check it out. What the system is doing? Just it is multiplying whatever the given input. So it multiply with n square. So that is the system how it is defined. So let us say this output is say y3 dash of n. Now what we are applying? The linear combination of inputs to the system. So what is y3 dash of n? So y3 dash of n is simply the input is multiplied with n square. Whatever the input we view to the system, just it multiplies with n square. So you can see that n square a into n square into x1 of n plus b into n square into x2 of n. So you can see from these two equations y3 of n, so y3 of n is equal to y3 dash of n. So therefore the linear combination of individual responses is equal to the response when linear combination of inputs is applied to the system. So therefore what the system is, since the system obeys superposition principle, so therefore this is a linear system. The system is a linear system. Or you can directly say from this equation y of n is proportional to x of n. So by observing this equation itself you can say that, so this system is a linear system. For example, if y of n is given as x square of n, that is non-linear system. Remember that. For example, in the same question, if it is given like this, y of n is equal to x square of n is given, remember that it is a non-linear system. So do it this one as exercise, x square of n. So let us see the second one. Let us see the second question. So what is the second question? So y of n is equal to x of n plus 1 by 2 into x of n minus 2. So what the system will do, system will give, when the x of n is given to the system, it will make the input like this and it will give the response of the system y of n. So first let us say x1 of n is the input to the system. What the system response or output? Y1 of n is equal to what the system will do to the given input. It make x1 of n plus 1 by 2 into, it will delay the input by 2 samples. So this the system will give the response like this for x1 of n as input to the system. So let us say y2 of n is equal to x2 of n plus 1 by 2 into x2 of n minus 2 if x2 of n is given to the system. So what we have to do, we have to add the individual responses. So let us call this as y3 of n. So what is y3 of n? A into y1 of n plus b into y2 of n. Just add these two. So the a into x1 of n plus a by 2 into x1 of n minus 2. So plus b into x2 of m plus b by 2 into x2 of n minus 2. So this is the linear combination of individual responses. So now let us apply the linear combination of inputs to the system. So what the system will do, so in place of x of n, we have to substitute a x1 of n plus b x2 of n. So the same input is delayed by two samples. So that is what we have to observe from the given equation. So therefore, what we can write it as y3 dash of n. So what we are applying, the linear combination of inputs, what the system will do, a x1 of n plus b x2 of n plus the same input a x1 of n plus b x2 of n is delayed by two samples as it is given. So a into x1 of n minus 2 plus b into x2 of n minus 2. So from these two equations you can clearly see that y3 of n is not equal to y3 dash of n. So therefore, what kind of system this is? This is a non-linear system. So this is a non-linear system. You can check like this. So let us see the next example. Let us see the third one. What is the third one given? So y of n is equal to 2 into x of n plus 4. So remember that if y of n is given as, for example, 2 into x of n, it is a linear system. Remember that. So there is a linear relation between y of n and x of n. This is a linear system. Suppose if it is given as a x of n plus b, it is a non-linear system. Remember that, though y of n, it looks like that y of n is proportional to x of n, you can mention that linear system. That is wrong. If any constant is there, so this system will become a non-linear system. Remember that. So just let us check it out. First, what, let us say x1 of n is the input applied to the system. What is the response y1 of n? What the system will do? The system will simply multiply the input with 2 and add 4. Let us say x2 of n is the input to the system. So what it will do? It just multiply with the input with 2 and it will add 4 to the system. 4 to the input actually. Now, so add the individual responses. So that is y3 of n. So that is equal to a into y1 of n plus b into y2 of n. So let us add these responses. So a, 2a into x1 of n plus 4a plus 2b into x2 of n plus 4b. So this is what your y3 of n is. Now what we will do is that we apply the linear combination of inputs to the system. Let us check out what that means. We are applying a x1 of n plus b x2 of n to the system. So what the system will do? System will simply multiply this input with 2 and with add 4. So therefore, that is called as y3 dash of n. What the system will do? So a into x1 of n plus b into x2 of n plus 4. You can see that 2a x1 of n plus 2b x2 of n plus 4. You can check that y3 of n is not equal to y3 dash of n. So therefore, the system is a non-linear system. The system is a non-linear system because it is not obeying the superposition principle. So let us see the fourth one. So let us see the fourth example. What is the fourth example? So y of n is equal to x of n into cos omega 0 n. So this is a linear system. You can slightly say that this is a linear system. The system multiplies the given input with cos omega 0 n and it will give the output. So that is what you have to observe. When x1 of n is applied to the system, what is the response? Y1 of n. So that is equal to x1 of n into cos omega 0 n. Let us apply x2 of n to the system. The response is, say, y2 of n. So that is equal to x2 of n into cos omega 0 n. So let us add the individual responses. That is y3 of n is equal to a into y1 of n plus b into y2 of n. So that is equal to just multiply y1 of n and y2 of n with a and b. So therefore you get a x1 of n cos omega 0 n plus b x2 of n cos omega 0 n. So what next step we have to do? We have to add the linear combination of inputs to the system. We have to apply the linear combination of inputs to the system. So let us call this as y3 dash of n. So therefore in place of this input x of n, let us apply the linear combination of inputs, that is a x1 of n plus b x2 of n to the system. And what the system will do? Just multiply with cos omega 0 n. So therefore you can see that a x1 of n cos omega 0 n plus b x2 of n cos omega 0 n. You can clearly see that y3 of n is equal to y3 dash of n. So therefore what kind of system? This is a linear system. Linear system since it obeys superposition principle. Linear system. Let us check the last example. Let us say, what is the fifth question given? The fifth question is given as y of n is equal to, so log base 10 mod x of n. You can clearly see that there is a non-linear relation between the output and input. The system is a non-linear system. So you can straightly say that non-linear system. So let us say x1 of n is the input to the system. What is the response? Y1 of n. So that is equal to log mod 10. So x1 of n. So let us say x2 of n is the input to the system. Y2 of n is equal to log mod 10 x2 of n. So add the individual responses. So that is y3 of n. So that is equal to a into y1 of n plus b into y2 of n. So that is equal to what we do? A into log mod 10 x1 of n plus b into log mod 10 x2 of n. So this is the adding individual responses of the system. Now, so what we apply? We apply the linear combination of inputs. What the system will do? The system will give this kind of response. Let us apply in place of x of n the linear combination of inputs b x2 of n. So you can check that. So y3 of n is not equal to y3 dash of n. So therefore the system is a non-linear system. You can say that the system is a non-linear system. In this way you can check whether the given system is a linear or non-linear system. Thank you.